In software engineering, we are taking chapter number 2, which is software engineering. The first thing is, today, the software making, building, employing and usage has changed. So in order to build software that is meeting the today's challenges, we need to know certain realities. The first thing is, software, apps, websites, etc. They are deeply embedded in every aspect of our life. Take real estate, take automotive industry, any. Everywhere we have software which is embedded. So for that we need a concerted effort, means the not only the effort but a full force effort to understand the problem. That is, the software is a solution for certain problem of the consumer or the client. So we need to understand the problem beforehand. The IT, information technology requirements. For everyone, it is different. For example, individuals, single person, maybe a big business, even for the government, state, union, federal, all requirements are different and they are changing, ever changing every year. Now I'll show you, this is the cockpit of an aircraft. Here we have embedded software, sophisticated software, you can say state-of-the-art software. So these software are now embedded, they are inside from your consumer electronics, microwave machine, etc. to medical devices, even to weapon systems, because here the lives are involved. That is very small thing, even bigger thing. That means the design becomes a very important activity. Software design. So this is a picture I wanted to show. So here is some catastrophic failure. This can be a result of anything, you know, but we don't want it to fail because of our software. That is, if the software fails, the individuals, people, the enterprises, some may experience very small, very minor inconvenience. Okay, they might not be worried about this. But sometimes if you see this picture, it may be catastrophic failure. That is, people will die. That is, your software should produce, give, exhibit high quality. Quality is the key. So as the, you know, users are increasing, the software apps people are using, so the requirement or the demand for adaptation, because user base is all about people. You are making for the people, by the people, for the people. So the software or the apps need, or they ought to be adaptable. That is, you can, this software may be made so that it can adapt and also can be enhanced as per user requirement. That is, the software needs to be maintainable. Maintainable means the change, configuration, management, all should be there. Software will change every time. So why we are discussing this? What is the conclusion? The conclusion is simple. That is, in any field of life, application domain, software is there. So this software needs to be engineered. You cannot just make as a final year project of your engineering or say of your class, your standard, you say 11th or 12th standard. You have to make it proper engineered, following a proper approach, giving quality, giving the solution for your customer. That's why we are reading and learning software engineering. So just now I said quality and maintainability, they will only come when you make a good design. All will depend upon the good design, maintainable, adaptable, enhanced. All this will come from design. And before you start, understand the problem first. Before understanding, if you start giving exam and don't understand the question, will you be able to give the answer properly? I doubt. How to define the software engineering? So, there are so many definitions, but a proper software engineering definition is given by IEEE. And there are two parts of this definition. The second part is referring to the first. Okay. This second part is actually the study of approaches which is being said in the part one. So, software engineering is all about applying the systematic, that is, everything needs to be planned. It follows some system, discipline, and quantifiable approach. That is, when you plan certain thing beforehand and follow that plan, and you have already in mind that this will be the quantification, this will be the number, this will be the output. So this, when we apply, for what? For the development, operation, and maintenance. That is, you are creating a software. You are going to make a software which will be operated by someone. And then you need to maintain it because some changes will be there. So all this, you have to apply the engineering aspect. Like a civil engineer makes a building. Like a mechanical engineer makes an automobile. So the study of these approaches which are being highlighted in the first is also comes under these definition of software engineering. Again, the application of systematic, disciplined, quantifiable approach to the development, operation, and maintenance of the software, that is, you are applying the engineering aspect to the software. This is the definition of software engineering. Now, software engineering is a layered approach. Let me give you a very naive example of what is layered thing. For example, let's say you eat burger. So you have the, you know, buns, bread, you can say. Then you have some burger, means you have some, say, potato or ham inside this. Then you will have some layer of tomatoes, cucumber, etc. Now these are the layering. Similarly, software engineering is a layered technology. So any engineering approach, as I said, it can be mechanical, civil, or any other. This all have a base, that is, they all rest on one thing: quality. So if you see these layers, these are four layers we are going to talk about in software engineering. The base is the quality, that is, you are making everything that has to have a focus related to quality, because you are going to give a quality product, you are making a quality product. Okay. If you go to Adidas or you go to a very general shop, you will see the difference, the stuff you take. So we have total quality management, Six Sigma, and many others we are going to talk when we will be discussing quality in detail. So these are different approaches which will make ascertain the quality. So whenever you make a house, there will be bedrock, that is, you know, some rocks. So this bedrock that will support the house, in this case that will support the software engineering, is basically a quality. The quality can be only given when you have a strong quality focus. Will only come when you have a very strengthened bedrock, right? That is, the you can rely and the customer can rely on your product. So above this quality, there is a second layer. This is the process layer. So when you put up bedrock, now you will lay the foundation of your house. This foundation is nothing but the process layer. So this process is, or process layer or process in software engineering, is a framework. So you just see this picture. Don't worry, we'll be discussing this in detail. But just now, or right now, you just understand that this process is nothing but a framework and a glue, because there are so many technologies that are involved. So it will hold these technology layers together. It is like a glue, right? It will hold these together. Because why we are doing this? We want to give the software timely. That is, there is no open-ended software development. Say 1 year, say 2 year or 6 months. So this is how the process layer work. Again, coming to the software processes, that is this process layer. What does it do? Actually, this is a basis. This is a base. So the software process provides the basis, or it is a basis for various other activities. For example, the management control, because the process will govern the management control. What are the technical methods you are applying? Because there are different processes any software team can have. So what are the technical methods you are going to apply? Technical means you can have a framework, you can have a programming language, you can talk about the kind of document you want. And you have work product, because the models will come out, the documents you are going to make, the requirement document, the acceptance test document, the data, the reports, the forms, all these, the basis is software processes. And you can decide the milestone, because this is how management control will take place. That is, in 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, what you are going to give or what you are achieving. And because of this only, you can ensure the quality at every moment, every time. And if certain changes are there, because change will come, so we will be able to manage properly these changes. Coming to the process, and now going to method, because I'm talking about layer, quality we have talked about, processes we have talked about, and now methods. So when we talk about software engineering methods, these are basically the technical how to build a software. That is, method you can have, oh, I will do this method. Say I will use the C sharp. Somebody says Python. I'm talking about programming language, but this programming language is going to work with what? Which hardware? With which different network devices? So this is the methods, technical how to's. Because ultimately you are building a software. For that you need technique, technical aspect, the programming aspect, the software aspect. For example, methods can be communication, because you need to talk, the requirement analysis, the design, the program construction, which I talked about, Python or C sharp, whichever, then the testing and the support. So these are the methods. Which method, what kind of method you will choose? It depends on you. Now coming to the tools. See, so what all you are doing is a theory. But finally, when you'll do it, you need some software. You might need, because requirement, design, implementation, verification, all these, and deployment, maintenance, this all will need some certain kinds of tools or software. So it can be automated. There are different tools, LDRA, and various companies are making. So this can be automated also, this can be semi-automated support also. And this is for what? These tools are basically for employing and implementing the processes and methods. So when these tools are integrated such that the output of one can be used as an input to the other. And these are all the systems which are supporting your software development only. That is what we call as CASE, computer aided software engineering. So this case is established. You see this integrated case. There are three activities which comes under uppercase: planning, analysis, design. Lowercase, that is computer-aided software engineering. The lower one are implementation, testing, and maintenance. So all these, the tools will help you to do or employ. The software processes. Now, software process or software processes. First, you have to look at the figure, but we'll be discussing it while we are discussing about the model. But the process is not one thing. It is collection of certain activities. What are the different activities different teams will perform? What are the actions you are going to take? I'll give you example of all these. And the tasks that are performed. Because you are creating some product. So whenever you are creating some work product means the product which is working. For that you have to do certain activities, certain action and task, and you combine them, that will be called as a process. And that is nothing but a software process. So let me tell you again, a process is the collection of activity, action and task for certain product, work product. So let us start with the activity, because there are three things involved which I have already underlined. So activity is achieving a certain broad or big objective. That is, let us take an example. Communication with stakeholders, communication with your customer. So stakeholders are basically, they may not be your customer, they are your customer, but they are people who are involved. They have profit and gain involved. They are connected to this production. So along with your customer, there are people who are called as stakeholders. So this activity, which is, as I said, having a broad objective, this, for example, communication, it has to be done for every project. Even if you go to medical field or say medical software or your automobile software, whatever will be the size of project, whether it is complex or simple or any kind of degree it has for the rigorousness, activity will be done. Okay, so a process defines who is doing what, when and how to reach a certain goal. Now there are three things, okay, in the process. What are action? The action, let us take an example also here. So action are certain small or you can say certain set of tasks. And when we combine this task, we are getting a major work product. For example, there are people who are in design, they are making architecture design. So when they combine this design, you are going to get the architectural design model of the software. Coming to the third part of process, task. The task focuses on a small, not very big, means minute or small, but whatever smallness they have, they are well defined objective they have. For example, you made a very small code, say a function, and then you will do a unit test. So it will give you a tangible outcome whether test is passed or failed. So the process we talked about is not a rigid having criteria, as any kind of rigidness is not there, because it is adaptable. Okay, if someone has to make a software in 2 months, someone has to make in 1 year, so the process may change. So the software team, those who are making the project, they can pick and choose, they can finalize what kind of actions they have to take, what kind of tasks they are going to apply. So software process are not rigid, because the basic idea, the intent, is to deliver a quality software timely. Not just timely delivery, but with the quality aspect. The process framework. We talked about process. It has activities, it has action, task, collection of that activities, which is giving you final product. So a process has a framework. So this process framework is basis of a software engineering aspect. So the process framework is a foundation for a complete software engineering process. So we are not only talking about whole, but there are certain framework activities, because process is a framework. When we talk about process framework, so there have to be some framework activities, and this has to be with all software projects. This is not only for one. So let us see what are the framework activities. These framework activities are those activities, those actions you are going to take that will come in a combined collective way will give you certain product. The first framework activity in a process framework is communication. Before doing anything, any kind of technical work, it is very important to communicate, to talk with customer. Why you are going to talk with the customer or stakeholders? Because you need to know what they want. You will gather all the information, we will gather all the requirement. Then only you will put features and function, the menu based, or so what kind of screen they want, what kind of action they want, they want it on which kind of machine. Okay, this only the user can tell you. The second thing comes is planning. See, if you are planning for a weekend, then if you are planning on say Monday, if you plan it earlier on Friday, you don't have to plan. So planning is actually a map. Wherever you go for your say holidays, you plan, because you have to plan a map for your journey. So here we are talking about map, and in the software term, in the process framework, in the framework activities, we are talking about software project plan. So we have already made a plan, that is, we have to make a plan. We need to decide what are the technical tasks, what are the work, what are the jobs we are going to do, and every task, what are the risks involved, we need to know. What are the resources required, the manpower, the systems, and what are the work products? Because when we define what are we are going to do, what we are going to achieve, and then in what time we are going to complete it, work schedule. So if you are an architect, you'll make a model. Nobody starts making a house. So that is, you know by the model a big picture that how my house is going to look. It may change, but the broad idea you will get. How the parts will be there, I will have a parking here, this will be my lift, and here I will have some generator I'll put. Similarly, because a software engineer is also a kind of architect, so software engineer has to create model to understand the software requirement, and then only you can design when you create a model, because you are going to achieve those requirements posed by the stakeholders and customers. Then once you design, you have to build. You design a model, then you have to build. So what you design must be built. So this is basically code generation. Here actual coding comes, programming comes. And once you program, then there may be some certain error, certain problems, certain bugs. So you need to uncover those errors, because you don't want it to propagate to the later step or schedule activity. So construction is actually building the software. And finally, once you made it, either you can give it directly, completely to the customer, or in an incremental way. So in an incremental way or a complete way also, you are giving it to the customer, because you want the customers to evaluate, to judge the software and provide you the feedback. Oh, I wanted this, you have given this, please change this. So these are the deployment activities. You are giving the customer to get the feedback when they evaluate it. See, software process for different case will be different, please remember. But the framework activities which I just told you, they will remain the same. They won't change for big software, small software, app, or even for website. For various projects, we have seen that these framework activities we just talked about, these are applied iteratively, that is in repetition, as the software progresses. So deployment, construction, this can be done again and again. It is iterative. because the iteration is a kind of increment, because once you iterate, you will add up some to the software, say X, you are adding now Y, you are adding now Z. So you are making a more complete software. Now there are certain umbrella activities, and this we are going to take in the next discussion. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.